I'm excited to introduce you to author Amber Joy Daniel. In my opinion, the most incredible book one can read is the Bible. And within the Bible is the account of Ruth. You probably know it well. But Amber has written a book using historical cultural information that may open your eyes to the account of Ruth in an entirely new way. The name of the book is Destiny Survivor, and the author is Amber Joy Daniel. I am thrilled to have Amber here in the studio. We've been talking a little bit before we got started. She has so many incredible things going on. I think we could talk for a couple hours. But today, we're going to talk about this book, mm-hmm. your first book.
My first book.
Destiny Survivor. Of course, we don't want to tell the whole story, but let's get into it and let's get the viewers hooked on this, why they want to read this.
Okay, so this is the story of Ruth. Kind of like told on steroids. So we go into all the little things that the nuances are there in the Bible, but we pull those out. So the fact that she was single, she was Moabite, which means that she should have married a good Moabitish boy. But no. She wanted something that looked and smelled and walked and talked a little differently. So, you know, in the Bible story, she wanted to marry the Jewish boy. And of course, we understand as well that the word says that Moabites, they were not allowed to mix with Jews. And then you have Ruth. So how does that happen? We tease out there a little bit what it's like to be different, what it's like to be accepted or not quite accepted. And then there are a few themes in there as well that people don't always realize, I think. She and her sister-in-law were married to brothers living side by side, and it had been about 10 years with no baby. And you know, back then, you were a woman and you existed to bear sons. If you bore daughters, you were okay, but you existed to bear sons. And she didn't in the first year, not in the second, the third, the fourth. And we kind of tease out waking up every morning and wondering, will today be the day my sister-in-law announces, we're having a baby? And you're not having a baby. And you know, as women, month after month, when that particular thing happens and you're like,
especially at that time,
at
when that
time
was your worth.
Yep. Yeah. And then, well, we skip from the hard parts into the really romantic parts where she meets Boaz. And there's a special relationship, though, a special mentoring relationship between Naomi and Ruth. And that is teased out as well. But the overarching story is one of a young woman who dares not to live out her fate, but to take her destiny. And that's a clarion call of the book. Each of us, God has a very special and unique destiny for us, but that doesn't come free. That comes often at a cost. And we know that Jesus paid it all. He paid everything. But there's a price that we need to pay to walk in the fullness of what God has for us. And that pretty much is the real push behind the book and the heart of the book to really inspire others to take that destiny journey.
So this is incredible, because what you have here is you have the account of Ruth, but like you said, on steroids. And I agree, because when I started reading this, I had to remind myself that I was reading the account of Ruth, because if you jump in the Bible, there's only certain elements that we read. Though I had always thought to myself, well, how did these guys both pass away, and how did all of this happen? And I love the way, from a historical, cultural standpoint, you make all of that come to life, not only very evidently, but also very interestingly. It draws you in. It causes you want to keep reading to figure out what's going to happen next, really bringing the book of Ruth to light in a new way.
Yes, and those two things were important. So I married it to a historian, so get your facts right. We do take some poetic license, but being married to my husband really gave me that impetus to want to do a lot of research into how things really work. So that's that piece. But then, as an avid reader growing up reading, I wanted to read a Christian book that gripped me. I wanted to read something that got me from page one and had me turning every page. And I think that our Holy Spirit really helped to make that a reality in this one.
So another thing I really like about the book is what you talked about, of the picture, what we can take away. This is more than just a historical fiction type book. I mean, we're coming from the Book of Ruth, but like she said, she took some poetic license with it. But it's not just about that. The reader can walk away from this with a better sense of how I am supposed to be in my life as well.
Yes, that was the idea. And so what we do in our normal lives for a job, that's what we do for a job. And so this was a way to bring that message maybe to a wider audience. Everybody may not be able to work with us one-on-one, but the book helps us to get that message out to all and sundry. Wherever you are, you can read this and access what we do.
Mm-hmm. This is your very first book. I'm guessing, though, this is not your first foray at writing. I mean, this is a well done book. It is well published. It does not appear as a starter book by any way, shape, or form.
Well, thank you. A lot of academic writing, a few degrees there, finishing up the doctorate this year. So there's been a lot of academic writing, but this was a very different style that I had to learn. And God is faithful and my editors are great.
So how do we get this book? We have more to talk about in a moment, but let's get to the nitty-gritty of how we get to this book. Go to your website. That's the first step.
So you can go, the book has a website. It's www.destinysurvivor.com. Same name of the book, Destiny Survivor, just www.destinysurvivor.com, and it's all there. You can also go to our website, which is destinystrategists.com. That's it.
All that information you see is right there on the screen. Of course, you can also contact us here at TV44, and we will make sure that we get you connected so that you can find the way to purchase the book. You have this week, get your calendar out because it's coming up this week. You've got some events going on. July the 29th, you're going to be at the Salina Library and you're going to be at the Wapakoneta Library.
Yes, we're working on Lima, but as of today, not as yet. But yes, on the 29th, we'll be at Salina at 1 p.m. and then we would be at Wapakoneta at 5 p.m.
And you'll be there with books.
We'll
books
be there
for
with
sale.
Books.
You'll sign
yes.
the books.
Yes.
It's always
yes.
fun to
yes.
meet an author. I mean, that just makes it even that much better. So you get to come and meet her personally. And I've only known her for about a half an hour now, and I can already tell you this is someone you want to hang out with. So there's your chance. You want to go. And then let's talk about the 5-day Destiny Survivor Challenge that runs from July 29th through August 2nd, 7 o'clock every night. July 29th through August 2nd, 7 o'clock every night. What is the 5-day Destiny Survivor Challenge?
Yeah, so based on the book, to get you to take your destiny, we want to do more than just talk shop, right? We want to give you practical strategies, tools that you can use to get from where you are to where God wants you to be. Mm-hmm. You want to be in the center of your destiny. Mm-hmm. That's where you want to, be an arrow that hits the bullseye, that gets your mm-hmm. target, that you're living the life you were meant to live. Mm-hmm. And so the challenge gives you an opportunity to get to know us, interface with us, but more than that, we'd be sharing for free, what we share with our clients. And the first step is to, a lot of people feel stuck. If you're stuck, or if you're a woman who wants more, if you're someone who knows there's got to be more than this, I have success, but I know there must be more. If you've been told you can have a career, you know, but you can't have a family, mm-hmm. or you're a wife and a mother and you know there's leadership locked inside. My degrees are in leadership development, so that's what we do. You know there's leadership inside, but you don't quite know, but I just don't know how to navigate this piece. Mm-hmm. That's what we do. And the 5 nights, we're going to give you tools to first identify where you are, identify where you want to go, and then tactics, strategies that will get you from here to there.
And how do people register for that?
So on our website, if you go to destinystrategists.com, www.destinystrategists.com, the link would be there. Even that, I'll put the link as well in the Destiny Survivor site. So either of those two sites, you'd have the opportunity to join the challenge there.
All right, I encourage you to get your copy of this book. It's fundraising, it's fun reading, easy reading, but also informative, inspiring, and like Amber mentioned, it'll impact you personally as well. And then also make sure you head to her website, destinystrategists.com is the main website where you can find out more information about that Survivor Challenge and more about the things that you offer, because you have a lot more than just the book. You are doing things that are really impacting people's lives, like you said, getting them to where God called them to be, and helping them know what they need to do to get there.
Yes, we have marriages, promotions, raises. Those are the types of things that our clients experience. And in a quick time, short time, we collapse time for our clients. So
God can work right like that, can he?
Yes, he can.
He can. Amber Joy Daniel, thank you so very much for joining us.
Thank you so
much. It has been a pleasure to have you
here. Thank you,
Jen.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.